Hello everybody, Dominic from CMAC here once again with another M50 tutorial. Today I'll be covering specifically the in-camera audio settings and how to use them in conjunction with the shotgun mic that comes with the kit. So let's get right to it. So before we get into the shotgun mic and how to set it up in more detail, I want to briefly go over some audio settings in the camera, so let's go ahead and do that. First, I'll make sure my camera is set to video record via the mode dial on top of the camera. Now I'll go into the menu and select shooting settings, and on this first page you'll see sound recording. Go ahead and choose that. You now see three different settings and maybe a set of audio meters at the bottom if your sound is already set to manual. Otherwise, let's take a look at sound record. This is where you decide to either have the camera auto set its input levels or you can manually adjust the level, which I'll get into in a sec. You also have a third option, disable, in case you don't want to record sound. But you should almost always record sound. For now, let's set it to manual. Now you should see the meters at the bottom of the screen going back and forth, each line indicating left and right channel respectively. You'll also see a set of numbers with negative dB 40 on the far left and increasing as you go right, negative 12 and 0. I won't go into super detail on these, but dB stands for decibels, and when it comes to recording sound, the sweet spot you should ideally want to be in is somewhere between negative 12 and negative 6. Anything higher than negative 6, you run the risk of peaking. You can see this with the meters turning yellow or red the closer you get to zero. Red is for peaking. This results in the audio sounding very distorted and blown out, and there's little to nothing you can do to fix that in post. The best rule of thumb is to try to have the mic as close to your subject as possible and set your levels accordingly. Now let's go over how to set your levels, which is the second option, record level. Here you'll see the meters at the bottom with the line at the top with left and right arrows. Pressing either one of these will either increase or decrease the mic input sensitivity, and you can see this effect in real time with the meters going up or down. Going back to the previous screen, you will see a third option for wind filter and attenuator. These are useful features as they're meant to help minimize distortion in your recording. The filter helps mitigate noise from wind, and the attenuator helps if you're in a noisy environment. Although you should be aware that if you have these settings turned on and if you're not in a windy or noisy environment, the recording could sound unnatural, so again, be aware of that. Now let's cover the shotgun mic. As I mentioned in previous M50 videos, the kit will come with its own shotgun mic as you can see here. It will have its own windscreen and a 3.5mm cable to plug into the camera. When you plug the mic into the camera, be sure to turn it on manually, otherwise the camera will not get any meter readings and sound. You can do so by holding down the button located at the top of the microphone. One thing you will notice is that the mic will have its own settings. On the back is a dial with numbers ranging from 0 to 10. This is the mic's own input sensitivity, very similar to the camera, 0 being the quietest and 10 being the most sensitive. The best thing to do is to set the shotgun's level anywhere from 7 to 9 and have the camera's level as low as possible. This will help minimize any preamp noise or hiss in the audio recording. Now going back to the button at the top, this is the camera's low cut filter, which is used to eliminate any low frequencies that will come up as a humming sound. Another thing to remember is that the mic will recognize when the camera is turned on or off and will turn itself off to save power, which you will see with the light at the top.
And that does it for this video tutorial on the M50 audio settings. Thank you so much for tuning in. You can catch this with other video tutorials on our CMAC social media platforms, including Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter via @CMACTV. And as always, on our cable and YouTube channels. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care, everybody.